Hi everyone and welcome back. This is actually our last presentation of the day and I'm really excited to announce not one but two female leaders, Florine de Nijs and Lineke Verest, both from Exact. Florine is Chief HR Officer and Lineke is Senior Marketeer Specialist. And together they have a whole lot of experience, including in the HR department. Today, they're going to talk about a growth versus a fixed mindset and how you can use these at work. So welcome Florine and Lineke, and I'll give the stage to you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm going to share our presentation, which we prepared and we'll share with you for the coming, I think, 20 minutes. Let me start with that. Lineke, you can all see it?
Yep, I see it.
Ah, good. Because we're really looking forward, because this is such an interesting topic. And let me start with first, hopefully it all works, because we prepared it so well, with our own introduction. Yeah, I'm going to start with myself, not the best way always, but this is how the slides are built up. My name is Florine Nijs, I'm working for Exact, working for HR. I live in Voorburg. I have two kids, two boys, 6 years old and 9 years old, always fighting. I love running and I love food, but I have to admit that lately during COVID times, food became more important to me than the running part. So that's something I have to catch up the coming summer period, I think. I worked in HR, but also I have a passion for sales and marketing, as I think that HR is really linked to all these topics. Before I joined Exact, I worked at KPMG, I worked at KPN and ABN AMRO, and I really liked the differences of all these companies, and I learned so much there. I studied communications, and I did my MBA at the Erasmus University, which is already some time ago. And during this presentation, I will share more about my career, but also about growth mindset, of course, the theme of this presentation. But I also would like to start because I started working when I was 20 and I studied during the evening hours. But I also wanted to share some highlights and tips maybe which are, could be useful for you as well. Because when I was thinking back and looking back, what were the tips that helped me most? There were a few, because I had a coach once and they told me that there's the two persons rule. Because I could be very down if somebody has a negative feedback to me and it made me really feel miserable and insecure. And then the coach told me that there are always two people who would tell you probably that you didn't do well, but the other 98 people will not tell you. So keep in mind that there were only two who were negative and focus on the positive ones. So don't focus too much on the negative people around you. Yeah, be you, stay you. I also mention that often. It's really the easiest way to work and to make a career. If you have to pretend you're somebody else, if you're doing something because you think that other people expect it from you, it will not work because it will be very tiring and you will fail someday because you're acting. So really stay who you are and it will make you the unique person that you are. Also, work hard and work smart. And it means that you don't have to work 60 hours a week. Sometimes I did, and I love my work, so that helps. But you also have to be smart when you do your work. And that means that sometimes at the right moment, when it's really crucial and you think it's an important deliverable, you just have to be there. So don't always go for the 10 or for the 11 rating, but you have to choose your moments and then be there. Do not forget to always have fun, of course, because it's work, but you also have a private life and the unique combination is important to you, but have fun during your career. And the last one is find a mentor. You don't have to do it yourself. I always had a mentor. It could be my manager, it could be a friend, it could be someone from other companies, but just to have that feedback and that conversation and somebody that could help you were really bring you further, I would say. Oh, last one, never assume. That was one that the manager always said to me when I thought, but she was going to do that, or wasn't he going to pick this up? And they said, never assume. check what you're going to deliver and really be focused on it. So these are the words that always come back to my mind. And even 20 years later, I think I still recall these. So that was my storyline. I'm going to send it over to you, Lieneke.
Hi all, I'm Lieneke. I'm a working mom of three kids. They are 7, 5, and 1 year old. You don't see running in my list of lifestyle, but it's mostly baking and food, which makes it also necessary to get the sporting there back in again. My skills, I work at the marketing department, but my basic skill is also storytelling. And I also see myself as a linking pin between teams and between people within teams. My background, I studied actually literature at the University of Leiden. So I'm I have nothing to do with my studies at this moment anymore. And after I graduated, I started working at the Heineken International. And after some very nice years, I went over to Sanoma, which is now called DPG, which is the publishing agency of many, at that time was publishing agency of many magazines. So some of you might know them. Then next slide, Florine. And my journey, I have also been working quite some time now. And one of the things that was really important for me is, and still is, make your plan before you become part of someone else's plan. So really think about what you want to reach or what I want to reach, because otherwise you kind of go with the flow, but it's always someone else's plan instead of yours. And another thing that has really helped me is ask questions and really listen to what is said. And there is never a stupid question. So if you don't, if I didn't understand something right, or if I wanted to learn more about a subject, not even always my work related, I always ask questions. Then a tip I got from a friend, she worked as a lawyer. She said, you have a to-do list. That's fine, but please make your ta-da list. So at the end of the day, normally when you have a to-do list, you have all these things that you didn't do. And you kind of might get frustrated from it. But if you have a ta-da list next to it, you see what you have accomplished during the day. And that is so much more fun to close your working day with. Then one thing I really put in it for me is enjoy the ride. So you probably have a goal or have something that you want to reach or a job you want to get or a level you want to get or a promotion. I really had to learn and live by the day and enjoy the ride. So enjoy all the years before I went to a new job or before I went to a new function. And it's really enjoying that ride that eventually will take you further. Florino's already said about having a mentor. I had, I still have mastermind sessions. That is sessions with, I have them with, most of them are people I learned to know during my jobs. Then you just come together, you discuss things you ran into in your job, in your work. It can be either really the content of your work, or it can be ways I need to deal with some kind of problem that I run into, or some person that I have to work with and I don't know how. I have a few people and I see them, well, now virtually monthly. And I can really check with them and they with me, and together you kind of brainstorm on how to improve yourself in that. One thing also I really had to learn is be patient. You don't have to do everything right now. And the other thing was really a big learning point. A closed door is an open window. I have lost my job once, and around me many people have had that, and it always opens a window and new opportunities. So don't let yourself be kicked back by it. So Florine, up to you.
Yeah, And we're that's what we also have in common. We're both working for Exact. And just to give you a bit of a highlight on the company Exact, we really enjoy working there. I worked there since, I think, 1.5 years. And I enjoy the open growth mindset also within the company. We have 1,850 colleagues working all over the world. 250 of them are working in Kuala Lumpur. And we are a software company. We make business software for SMEs and accountants. We have quite some companies who are our customers, like you see here, 550,000. And our head office is based in Delft. But as you know, offices are now different. They're just working locations because we all have an office at home at this moment. So wherever you live, I think you can join Exact because it's a global company, and with a hybrid way of working as we're doing, you work from home, you work from the office, and hopefully in the coming months that will develop further, because now we're all working from home. This presentation, we would like to introduce a bit more about growth mindset, because we're quite enthusiastic about it, and we think it's an important topic for you as well, as it can influence your career and the next years to come. But it also can influence the mindset and the situation you are in, because we're now in a working from home COVID situation. And also then the growth mindset can help you further. It really can shift your thinking.
Okay, for the next slide, you can click a couple of times and it ends with the red one. So why do we have this slide? And it's all in Dutch. I think one more click, Florine. Yep. It's all in Dutch. It's things, this is especially around female entrepreneurship and female workforce. And it's about the things that you run into working as a woman, even if you have your own company, if you work in a big company, if you work as a tennis player, everywhere you can run into a discussion regarding gender, regarding the way you work, regarding part-time, full-time, the money that you receive, everything is always a discussion. And even from the report that we read from Magnet and me, it said that women are many times unhappier in their first job than men. And also the women that have their first job have, they run into the things like, how do you say it? The culture at companies, and that keeps them from growing. And I think if you take these things into consideration, the coin will drop when we talk about growth mindset. So,
yeah, this is what is a growth mindset? And you can just read it out yourself, of course. It's important to remember that you're in control of your own mindset. You can change how you view the world and how you respond to situations and events. Learning to utilize a growth mindset and viewing obstacles as opportunities. To learn will help you to enhance your performance, focus, and feeling of being in control of your own destiny. And that is the key of the growth mindset. We will share a bit more about that, because there are quite some typical growth mindset behavior and fixed mindset behavior. If you are a fixed mindset person, you are afraid to make mistakes and you're probably a perfectionist. And if you will receive feedback, you deny it, you neglect it, or you feel that it's a threat to you, so you ignore it most of the time. And if you see colleagues around you or friends or students around you who are successful, the fixed mindset person gets jealous. They feel that the other person is doing something or wrong or luck, but it's jealousy that comes up. If you look at the growth mindset persons, they believe in talents. They believe and love to learn, because everything is an opportunity to learn. And if you get feedback, although it might be negative, growth mindset people will see it as an opportunity again. They think, okay, it is a common comment that I receive, and I can learn something from it. And if you compare it to the fixed mindset persons, growth mindset, you see other people with success, and that's again a learning moment. Every moment is a learning moment. That's, I think, is the key of this one. And we think that it is important for you to also think about what kind of mindset do you have. And be aware of your own beliefs and learn to recognize your own mindset. We will share a bit more about that later on. And try to replace your fixed mindset thinking by growth thinking. And that's the start. If you learn to recognize it, you're also able and capable to change it. And it will help you to get in that growth flow. We will share more later. I will go to the next slide. And it's not an absolute thing. That's important to know. So it's not that you are one person or you are the other one. So it's not that you always have that growth mindset or that fixed mindset. But we all have to deal with our disappointments in life and with stress. And the key thing with growth mindset is that you learn to recognize your fixed mindset thinking and that you realize that there are alternatives. You can really change your way of thinking. And with that, also the future. You cannot change the past, but you can change the future with the way you think. There are a few fundamentals that we shared already a bit about the fixed mindset. And this slide is just to make you realize that it's all within your own mind. You can control it. And later on, we will share another few of the tips how to, for you to also recognize it. And it's not just us who think it's important. We have two people you probably know, Oprah Winfrey, Steve Jobs. And we found some quotes from them that also state the growth mindset and the growth way of thinking. Mr. Steve Jobs, he said, "The only way to do great work is to love what you do. How simple is that? If you did not found it yet, keep looking and don't settle." That's also what we said before. You are in control. And Oprah Winfrey, I don't think she's on television that often anymore, but some people may not know her or didn't see the shows. I did. And if you really want to fly, you have to harness your power to your passion. Honor your calling, and everyone has one. So they're all stimulating that really growth mindset and that positive flow, I would say. And you can also develop this. Please have a look at the list and you see the differences. I'm not good at it. That's really a fixed mindset. Or what am I missing? Can I find other solutions? I give up. Or I'll use a different strategy. Oh no, it's not good enough again. Oh, is this really my best work? Just some examples, and I would just have a look at it. And you see that one part is always thinking in negatives, in I made a mistake, I just cannot do this, but you always can turn all these situations around. I'm going to do this. I'm going to make this happen. I will learn from them. And we all can do that. And don't let other people you can't, because you're in control yourself. Lieneke, we had 4 tips for growth mindset still.
Yes. You can start with the first one.
Here it is. This is realize you are a child of your generation. With all the reading we did, we also saw that it is important to realize we're having a growth mindset or a fixed mindset, but it's also something we want to share with you, that we are from different generations. And that could also mean that people respond to you differently. And if you're from a generation millennial or generation X, you totally have other behavior and a few work and private life than maybe your manager has or your future employer. And it's good to realize that and read something about it to recognize other one behavior.
And did you also run into something like that, Florine, when you work, that you see that the way you work is within different generations?
Yeah, I really noticed that. And it feels like being old a lot of times. But it's good to see, for instance, that the younger people working in my team have other preferences and make other choices in life. For instance, that private life and work life should be more balanced. And by knowing and recognizing this, we could have better conversations about it, because it's not my way of working which fits all. I think to realize that is important to managers, but also to people joining this call to realize that.
Okay, then tip two is from me, it's fail your way to success. And it's really, sometimes I think every day I make mistakes. And every day I make mistakes at home with my kids. I haven't studied for being a mom. So I'm just doing my best at it and I learn from it. And that is the most important thing. Also in my job, I make mistakes or I forget things. The key when you have a growth mindset is that you recognize that you make a mistake, you recognize that you failed in something, and that is okay. And it's not bad at all, actually. It gives you, if you take the time to reflect to it and think, okay, what went wrong? And how can I prevent this? Or how can I do this better? Or why did I do something wrong? The next time when you run into a situation that is like the one you are in, you will notice that you will act differently. And that is the growth mindset. And we are with me, I think, in teams that I work and in people that I meet, it's so hard for us to say, okay, I failed or I made a mistake. And I think that is a fixed mindset within companies that you're not allowed to fail. But it's a growth mindset for me, for the company, for people to think I failed and I'm open about it and it's okay.
Yeah, that's what we also do within Exact at this moment, isn't it? That we also say it's okay to say no. For instance, when you find it difficult to work from home or you have that there's too much workload. And the last year, it was really a challenge to a lot of people. And our mantra almost was, it's okay to say no and be open if you cannot cope with it or you need help. And I think that the best way to manage yourself is to be open and honest about that.
Yeah,
third one is to be clear on what you need and ask for help. And I think that also has to do with the previous one, that do not try to be somebody or pretend you are somebody. You don't have to be as strong as you think other people are, but ask for help. I did so many times and people are so willing to help, and don't try to solve it yourself. But also be clear on what you need, because people can, your colleagues or your students or can share what they think that you need, but it's you who has to really state that. Lineke, do you have something to add?
Well, I think this actually was a tip that also was mentioned in another time when we were presenting together. When you said this, we are so humble, especially women are so humble by not expressing what they actually want or what they want to achieve or where they want to grow or a project that they want to do, and they don't stand up or raise their hand or not enough. So I think that is also in being clear. So asking help and being clear is on that as, yeah.
Last but not least.
The final tip is, and that's really something I keep saying now, and I'm 40, so I'm very old in for people that are listening. You don't have to reach your goal before you're 30. I think everybody has his dream goals and his dreams and ambitions and what you want to do and what you want to become. And I have done the same thing. When I graduated, when I was 25, I was running and racing, and I really wanted to do kind of, I think in my mind, I wanted to be like top level before 35. And then just life happened and things happened. And in the end, I'm 40 now and I have so much clearer view on where I want to be and what is important for me. And you have all the time in the world. We have to work for a very long time, and it's good to make sidesteps. Not only rush forward because you think your way is that way, just allow yourself to learn also in what you like and what you find important. I think that's also
it's a great link to the mindset thing again, because growth mindset is people who look at the journey instead of always looking out for the goal. So fixed mindset is really focused on the result and the end state. A growth mindset is enjoying the journey and see opportunities when they are there. So I think that's also linked to your tip here.
Yep.
And there's so much more we can share on this. In case there was some time left, we would like to share with you, because we did quite some reading and it's a topic that we work on every day, also within Exact. It's a central theme, also within our leadership journey. And maybe, Lieneke, you want to share a few? I would like to share that Simon Sinek, watch it on YouTube, because there are really interesting videos about growth mindset, but also on differences in millennials or managers. And I think it's worth spending some time there.
Yeah, I have two books on there. One is on a personal level. It's Brain Balance. And that is also it's how you can train your brain in growing. So that's really interesting if you want. It's not business related, but it's really brain related. And the other one I really like, and that's also referring to a couple of times when we said ask questions, ask for help. It's a Dutch book, though. Socrates op Sneakers is really about how to ask the right thing. So how to create a good question. And what is a good question? And how do you get a good question to put into a conversation? So I would, yeah, I really enjoyed reading those.
To the end of our presentation, we could spend, is it still there? We can spend hours on this topic, of course. If you have questions, I think it's possible to share them now. But also, if you could link with us via LinkedIn, it would be great. And we can, we're open to your questions and are willing to help anywhere we can. So hope to meet you there.
Thank you so much, Florine and Lieneke. I think that was incredibly insightful and valuable to learn a little bit more about how a growth mindset works. So we actually have a couple of questions. I think the first one is a little bit more about both of your career paths. Michelle is asking, how did you find your mentors? I'm not sure if you have any right now, but yeah, how did you find those?
Yeah, to me, it's a mix of best friends, people at work that I thought they're role models to me, but also people who are working next to me. It could be anybody. And I think it's do not think that it's difficult or that you're asking them too much, but because I found out that they really like helping you, like I like to mentor myself now. If I can help somebody else, it gives me energy. So that's the other way around as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I have the same. Most of the people I have my masterminds with are people from previous jobs, but also one person who actually... still working with, but she's in another team. And I have found one person via LinkedIn, because I was running into a question for myself, and I just posted it on LinkedIn if there was anyone within my network who could help me with it. And we kept talking. And
ask hard. How do you maintain a growth mindset even when things turn out to be hard? Because you might be more inclined to go back to your old way of thinking, which might be a more fixed growth. A fixed mindset. How do you stay within that growth mindset in those moments?
Yeah, I don't know if you always have to stay in the growth mindset. I think the key thing here is awareness, and that you learn to be aware of your own behavior. And life can be shit sometimes and life can be difficult and you have a choice how you deal with it. And I think it's important to realize the choices you are making and the things that are in your head. Can you control it and can you change this? And do you want to change it? Because sometimes fixed mindset is also okay. And it's who you are and it's your first response. But if you just learn to recognize it, you're already making big steps.
Yeah, I think so. You don't have to have a growth mindset for everything. And make things smaller. If you run into something and it sets you back, just try to take little things out of it and try to grow in there and leave the rest and be sad or be unhappy on that. That's okay.
Well, I actually think that that's a great way to end today, because what you are pointing out, just be aware of these different tools and tips and things that you can do in your career, especially as a young professional woman, is why we're having this event. You don't have to change overnight and apply everything that all our speakers just told, but just know that that there are different ways of advancing your career however you want to. So Florien and Lienke, I really want to thank you for joining today. And with that, I also want to thank everybody for joining us, because we've come to pretty much the end of the event, of our Women in Career event. We have a couple of minutes left until 1:30. So if anybody has any questions for employers, including exec, you can find them in the expo area. And of course, also feel free to ask us any questions afterwards as well. We want to help you as much as we can in your career. So yeah, with that said, thank you so much. Have a great day. And thank you, Lienke and Florien.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Have a good day. Bye.